we filming? So, you've clicked the link, you've seen the title, and probably thought, oh, another PLC programming training for beginners, right? And you'd be absolutely correct, except that instead of explaining each and every feature of a PLC, we'll take a simple real-world application and step-by-step write a control program for it, gradually introducing PLC features and technologies. Who is this course for? Mainly for beginners. We'll try to keep things as simple as possible without oversimplifying. That means we would expect you to have general understanding of what a PLC is and things like Boolean logic or PID control. But at the same time, we will skip many advanced things which real-life project would have in it, like I/O isolation layer, modularization, process simulation module, unit testing, etc. So, what's the application? We'll be working with PLC which controls district heating substation. Why exactly this application as an example, you might ask? Well, first, it's relatively simple. Second, it has digital and analog logic in it. Third, it is something most inhabitants of urban areas may find around them. And fourth, well, we had to choose something, right? So let's have a closer look on what we're going to work with. Typical district heating system of urban area usually has one or more thermal power plants which generate hot water by burning fossil fuel or by gathering energy from sustainable sources. Then hot water is being transported by the network of pipes to various types of consumers. It could be your quiet suburban neighborhood, populated residential area with various local businesses, or busy city center with all its banks and offices. Usually hot water from power plant doesn't flow directly into the heater in your, let's say, bedroom, but rather goes through heating substation. Main purpose of which is to adjust temperature, account heat energy, and separate different networks. To understand how heating substation works, we need to get a little bit deeper. Hot water is being pumped from heating network to a heat exchanger. In the heat exchanger, water of internal heating network of a building is heated up and then being pumped by one of two redundant pumps to consumers, where it enables heaters to warm up room. Cooled water from consumer returns to the heat exchanger and process repeats again. Ahead of the heat exchanger, control valve is installed, which regulates amount of water pumped through the heat exchanger and therefore amount of heat energy supplied to consumers. To be able to control the process effectively, following measurements are made. Ambient air temperature, water temperature after heat exchanger, water temperature before heat exchanger, pressure before and after pumps to fill up the system with water when winter season starts, and to maintain constant pressure during operation, two redundant pumps of feeding system are used. From electrical standpoint, the whole system is built around four pumps. Pumps 1 and 2 are supplied through a variable speed drive, which makes it possible to adjust water flow according to the process needs. A pair of conductors are used to connect either motor to the variable speed drive. If variable speed drive fails, each motor has a bypass direct online starter. Pumps 3 and 4 are supplied directly from the network by direct online starters. From control circuit's point of view, each pump has auto-manual mode switch, which makes it possible to start each pump manually without control system. In auto mode, all pumps are controlled by PLC outputs. All mode switches are as well connected to the PLC inputs. Suction and discharge pressure transmitters are connected to PLC analog I/O option boards. PT1000 temperature transmitters, which measure ambient temperature, supply and return water temperature, are connected to an analog I/O module. ACS480 variable speed drive is controlled by analog and digital signals from the PLC and gives back digital signal ready. Another important part of the system is the control valve KV1 and gate valve KV2. The control valve has two control terminals, open and close, which are connected to PLC outputs through isolation relays. The gate valve has only open terminal, which in the same way connected to the PLC through a relay. To sum up the PLC part, we have a PM5072 AC500 Eco CPU module with embedded I/O channels and TA5120 analog I/O option board inserted into one of the CPU's option slots. Additional DA501 analog digital I/O module is attached to the CPU from the right. So, what do you say? Ready for a little adventure? Then get yourself a cup of something and let's get started. And by the way, my name is Yuri Kuzmich. I'm from ABB PLC Center of Expertise here in Heidelberg, Germany. Now we can start.